Yes, welcome back. And today, since we're talking about secondhand shopping, I thought I'd talk to you guys about what I wear to work that I have thrifted or bought secondhand, either from eBay, from the Facebook Marketplace, or actual thrift stores like Salvos, Venice, and U-Turn Vintage. Do I have anything from U-Turn Vintage here? I don't think so. Anyway, I am going to put on some corporate outfits, and these are actual clothes that I wear to work. Now, just a disclaimer, some of you might have a more casual work environment. Mine is very, very corporate. Like, suits are the way to go. Okay, so I thought I would wear a neutral tank top and show you guys what are the things that I have found on secondhand in the second market that you can buy, okay, and use for work without having to break the bank, because all of these ones that I'm going to be showing you are pretty affordable. Like a full suit, like a blazer and either trousers or skirts for roughly $50. Okay, let's get on with it. So another disclaimer before I continue is that I normally would be wearing a button-down shirt as my inner shirt with my blazers, but just for the purpose of this video and to make it easier for me to change in and out of clothing, I am wearing a tank top. Okay, so the blazer and the skirt that I am wearing, and don't worry because I'm going to do a full-on sort of like cutaway for you to see what it looks like. The blazer is by Q, and I got this off of eBay, and I believe I paid something like $50 for the set, if I'm not mistaken. Let me go ahead and check that, since I've got my phone here somewhere. Okay, so this set that I am wearing right now, like I said, is from eBay, and it was purchased for $35, so it's $50 including the shipping to my house. So it's a size 10, and it has this skirt as a partner, but this one is more of a flowy skirt, is it called an A-line skirt? It's not a pencil skirt, okay. And the shoes that I'm wearing here are the Mimco shoes that I also got off of eBay for $35 as well. I paid a total of $52 to include the shipping, and it hasn't even been worn yet. So you can see in the mirror reflection the shoe and the skirt. Now I've done some investigating and found out that this outfit from Q, this blazer, would have cost about $380, and the skirt is roughly about $200. So the whole set would have been around $580 to $600 brand new, and I got it for $35 plus shipping. So, loving that. Totally loving the look and the vibe of this sort of corporate but kind of schoolgirl chic outfit. The shoes would have cost something around $200, so the whole outfit is around $800 brand new, and I paid $70 for the whole thing. Alright, now this dress that I have on, which is a little bit tight around here, okay, this is from Forever New, and this by itself will not be allowed at work because it is a tad too short. I don't know if you can see it, but the hemline is right here, and it's about 2 inches too short because the prescribed length of skirts at my workplace is that it has to be knee length. So this is a little bit too short. I could definitely wear this by itself outside of work, but not at the workplace. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this as a top. And there you go. I put on a blazer. This blazer is by Jigsaw. Now the dress that I just turned into a skirt, I got from the Kirribilli Markets for $10. They are by Forever New originally. This would have set me back around maybe $80 to $90 brand new, maybe even more. The Jigsaw, the Jigsaw jacket is around $400, and the skirt is around $180 to $200. So the whole set would have cost me about 600 plus, yeah, about $700 for the top, the blazer, and the skirt. Now my skirt is a pencil skirt. I'm going to also show you the bottom because I changed shoes as well. Okay, so this is a pencil skirt that I've got on. And then my shoes are the Karen Millen shoes. And these are roughly around $200 to $250 here in Australia. So my whole outfit is almost $1,000. But I got the set. The shoes were $20 off of Salvo's in Tempe. And then my blazer and my skirt, I got for the whole set for $35 off of Vinny's in Crow's Nest. So from almost $1,000 to $55 is not bad. Now this dress here is by Veronica Main, and it would have cost $250 brand new, but I got it for $20 off of Vinny's in Crow's Nest. Now it's got a pencil sort of like design skirt, very, very straight, and a very structured waist. So sometimes when I've eaten too much, I have to wear a corset. I broke it up with a black leather belt that I don't even remember how long I've had this belt for. And I usually also wear this with a black jacket, like this one here. This is my G2000 blazer that I've had for 6 years. So this is usually what I pair together. Now when I wore this to work, right now I'm wearing it with, and I'm going to go ahead and show you the bottoms. Okay, so right now I'm wearing it with my Karen Millen pumps, which I got for $20 off of Vinny's in Tempe. But when I wore this dress to work, I actually wore it with also a pointed shoe, but it's red, like Merlot color, and it was by Diana Ferrari. I got that for $12 unworn, brand new without the tags, from Salvo's in Montevale. Okay. Diana Ferrari shoes usually are over $100. So $12 plus $20, $32 for what would have been about $350 worth. Next we've got here this pantsuit from Charlie Brown, which is carried by David Jones here in Sydney. So that's the department store. And I've got here a blazer and a pant, a trouser set, so a pantsuit. And this would have cost the pair almost $600 as well, between $500 and $600. And I got this for $25 for the set. So that's like 5% off the original price. I'm wearing it currently with that Mimco shoes that I showed a little bit earlier that I got for $35 in eBay. So $25 plus $35 is $60, as opposed to what would have been about $750. So less than 10% of what the actual cost would have been, right? So almost $600 plus $200. Oh, actually it's $750 to $850 would have been the cost of the set. Yep. Very, very formal looking. I also have another set off. I'm not going to wear it anymore because it kind of looks the same. So this is a jacket with trousers as well. This is by Basque. And I got this set for, it was $20 off the Mustard Seed Op Shop here in Piermont. And this whole suit would have cost about $580, the trousers and the blazer, not including the shirt. So there are really a great bargain and good, beautiful products that are out there in the secondhand market. This Charlie Brown suit, I got off at Vinny's in Crow's Nest together with my Veronica Main dress and my Jigsaw suit. So yeah, you don't have to spend a lot of money for you to be able to look presentable at work. You just need to know where to find it. And you probably shouldn't be too squeamish about wearing secondhand items because you can always wash them. But I'm telling you this, when I got this Basque suit, it still had the tag from it being sent to the dry cleaners. But obviously, I didn't take that as the word, I went ahead and washed it as well myself, and then I ironed it. Okay, that's another thing. Make sure you iron your clothes. Obviously, as I'm wearing this right now, I haven't because I just took it out of the laundry hanger. But iron your clothes to make you look a lot more polished and professional. Okay. Now I do have some options for a more casual office. So I'm gonna show you two options that I have. Okay, so I'm gonna bring you here in front of the mirror, and I'll show you that this is a black and white polka dot dress that I swapped. There was a clothing swap on Instagram here in Australia, and I got this. I could totally wear this by itself and just wear it with pumps, so I'll show you. So I've got these on, just to show you what that looks like from head to toe. So shoes, I could totally do that and just put on a blazer if I wanted to. Well, actually I'm required to at work, so let me put on a blazer. Like so. So then it becomes a lot more presentable. And because of the length of the dress, you could totally get away with using this at work. And you've already got your inside shirt as well. You could totally button that up. You could even go as far as getting a belt and putting that around, covering the button off of that. So you could go like that. Or you could also do the belt and the inside around the actual dress. To break up the pattern and then have I'm very glad that I got this dress. I swapped it with my faux Burberry laptop bag. And now that I'm wearing it like this, I can totally rock this to work. I might even wear it on Monday. There you go. So that's one. If your office allows you to be a little bit more casual than that, you could also go with, instead of like a traditional tailored blazer, I have here my Burberry sort of like military almost jacket that is more on the sort of like gray side. Put that on. Okay, you could totally do that. I normally would like to wear this jacket with the sleeves scrunched up, like so. And it gives you that sort of like corporate-y, but also trendy, but also fashionista. And you can even go with, I usually wear socks, believe me. But you can also go with your like boots, especially during the winter. Yep. And look like that. So let me just pan you down so you can see what the boots look like as well. So there you go. So you could totally rock this sort of like casual vibe with this dress and your nice boots. So there you have it. So like I said, and you can't see me because there we go. So yes, you don't have to spend a fortune to look presentable at work. There are a lot of still good quality products and clothing and shoes that are out in the secondhand market. My Burberry jacket, even though it's Burberry, I paid $70 for it from eBay. The dress I swapped, so technically I didn't spend any money except for shipping. I swapped it with a laptop bag, a fake Burberry laptop bag that I don't even use. So I, one, decluttered that one item, but got in return a beautiful dress that I can wear either at work or even at play. So I hope you like this video. Let me know in the comment section down below if you want to see a little bit more about corporate styling and what I normally wear to work or whatever kind of styling that you prefer. I'm not by any means a stylist or a fashionista, but I will share with you what I know and what I have found in the secondhand market so that you can definitely say that, oh, I don't need to spend thousands of dollars to get good brands, because you can definitely get those in the secondhand market. Thank you for watching. I'll see you all again in the next video. Bye.